So hi everyone and a very good evening to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams and especially for the upcoming RBI Grade B exam. Alright, so let's begin with the session and let's talk about the very first question. But before I begin, let me tell you that we have launched the crash course for the upcoming RBI Grade B exam 2022. In this course, you can get the downloadable PDF of the entire syllabus of RBI, the lectures explaining all the important concepts, and you can get the monthly PDF, you can get the PIB 247 monthly PDFs, RBI 247 monthly PDFs, mock test and everything, alright. And if you want to join this course, you can download this app from your Google Play Store. And if you want to ask anything related to examination, you can follow me here. And if you want the PDF of this session, you can join the Telegram channel, the link for which is provided in the description. Alright, so let's begin with very first question, which says, which software has been launched on iSTEM to enhance the research and development collaboration and skill development across the country? Kaun sa software iSTEM ke upar launch kiya hai? Okay, so let's talk about this. Remember, the name of the software is MATLAB. And ye MATLAB hai, matlab nahi hai, theek hai? This is MATLAB. So MATLAB software has been launched on iSTEM. And what is the meaning of iSTEM, by the way? It is Indian Science Technology and Engineering Facilities Map Portal. This is an initiative of the Principal of Scientific Advisor to India, to the Government of India, who is Professor Vijay Raghavan. Ye jo hamara iSTEM hai, ye kiska initiative hai? Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India ka. And kaun hai hamare Principal Scientific Advisor? Professor Vijay Raghavan. Now this MATLAB software has been launched to enhance the research and development collaboration and skill development across the country. Alright. Now talking more about MATLAB. So remember, the full form is Matrix Laboratory. MATLAB is an acronym for Matrix Laboratory, and it is a software that provides multi-paradigm programming language and also numeric computing environment. Ye agar yaad nahi bhi rehta, toh then there is no issue. Alright. But do remember that it has been developed by MathWorks, ठीक है? इसको किसने डेवलप किया था? MathWorks नाम की एक कंपनी ने, and it is basically a programming language software, alright? And talking about iSTEM, so that is very important. iSTEM के बारे में पढ़ना काफी ज़्यादा important है, because it is an initiative of the Principal of Scientific Advisor to the Government of India, जो कि मैंने आपको already बता दिया. It was launched in 2020 by Honorable Prime Minister of the country. And it is a national web portal for sharing research and development facilities. ये basically क्या है? एक national web portal है जहाँ पे R&D facilities से related information share की जाती है. Alright. This iSTEM, remember, aims to strengthen the R&D ecosystem of the country. And how will this strengthen the R&D ecosystem, by the way? By connecting researchers with the resources which are available in India, by promoting technologies and scientific equipment development इंडिजीनियसली. टेक्नोलॉजी को प्रमोट करके और जो साइंटिफिक इक्विपमेंट है उसको इंडिजीनियसली डेवलप करके, दिस iSTEM पोर्टल विल स्ट्रेंथन, इज बेसिकली एम्ड टू स्ट्रेंथन द R&D इकोसिस्टम ऑफ द कंट्री. ऑलराइट. एंड रिसेंटली द इट्स फेज टू हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड एंड इट हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड टिल 2026. ऑलराइट. सो आई होप गाइस दिस इज क्लियर. एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी व्हाट? ऑप्शन बी, MATLAB. ऑप्शन बी, MATLAB. एंड याद रखना, मतलब नहीं है, मतलब मत बोल देना. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आई विल से. अंडर जल जीवन मिशन, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति हैज अवॉर्डेड परफॉर्मेंस इंसेंटिव टू 6 स्टेट्स. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट वन ऑफ द 6 स्टेट्स? मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति, रिमेंबर, इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर गजेंद्र सिंह शेखावत एंड हिज लोकसभा कंस्टिट्यूएंसी इज जोधपुर, विच इज ऑफकोर्स इन राजस्थान. ऑलराइट. And under Jal Jeevan Mission, the government has the target to provide tap water connections, tap water to all the rural households by the year 2024. 2024 तक जितने भी rural households हैं हमारे देश में, सबको tap water दे दिया जाएगा. This is the target of this Jal Jeevan Mission, and it is being implemented by the Ministry of Jal Shakti only. All right. So talking about this news, so remember the performance incentives under Jal Jeevan Mission has been provided to 6 states across the country, and these are Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur, Meghalaya, Sikkim, Tripura and Himachal Pradesh. Theek hai, do remember the names of these states. Okay, very important. So all these states have qualified for performance incentive grant for the previous financial year under Jal Jeevan Mission because of their exceptional performance in providing the tap water connection in the rural areas. All right. Now the objective behind giving this performance incentive is to foster the healthy competition among all the states and UTs so that they will also get motivated for speedy implementation of this particular mission in their respective states or UTs. All right. And remember, the total amount of incentive is 1982 crores. Out of this, Arunachal Pradesh will get 542 crores, Manipur 120 crores, Meghalaya 400, Sikkim 70 crores, Tripura 100 crores, and Himachal Pradesh has got the highest incentive of rupees 750 crores. Now these individual amounts are not important for your exam unless ki aapki kismat kharab hai, theek hai, agar kismat kharab hui to exam mein pucha ja sakta hai, otherwise it is not that important. All right, and just remember the total incentive, that is 1982 crores. And now let's come back to the question. So which of the following is not one of the six states? So Manipur is there, Meghalaya, Tripura, Himachal Pradesh, Gujarat is not there. So option E, Gujarat, is the correct answer to this question. And I hope guys this question is clear. And now let's move ahead to question number 3, PM YUVA scheme ke bare mein hai ye. So you have to identify the incorrect statement with respect to PM YUVA scheme. All right, this was launched last year, 2021 mein ye launch hua hai, and a written reply has been submitted in the parliament regarding this. And kyunki ye 2021 mein hi launch hua hai and it is a recently launched scheme, so it automatically becomes important for your upcoming RBI grade B exam. Okay, so let's talk about this scheme. So what is the objective, by the way? So this is for promoting the reading, writing and book culture in the country by mentoring and training the young and budding authors. ठीक है, जो हमारे जवान और budding authors हैं, ठीक है, जो आने वाले authors हैं, basically उनको train किया जाएगा, उनको mentorship provide कराई जाएगी under this PM YUVA program. Okay, ताकि हमारे देश में reading, writing और जो book culture है उसको promote किया जा सके. And it was launched last year. It is being implemented by Ministry of Education. However, the nodal implementing agency is National Book Trust. All right. Now remember, under this PM YUVA, what will happen is that the government will provide scholarship amount. The government will provide scholarship amount of rupees 50,000 to the selected authors. Now how these authors have been selected? So these authors have been selected through a contest which was organized to select these 75 young authors. और यहाँ पे याद रखना, जो एलिजिबल एज है बेनिफिशियरी की, दैट शुड बी लेस देन 30 इयर्स. यंग ऑथर का मतलब यहाँ पे 50 साल का नहीं है, यंग ऑथर का मतलब है यहाँ पे लेस देन 30 इयर्स. ऑलराइट, एंड दीज ऑथर्स वर सिलेक्टेड बाय अ कमिटी कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड बाय द नेशनल बुक ट्रस्ट. एंड एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट अ कंसोलिडेटेड स्कॉलरशिप ऑफ ₹50,000 पर मंथ फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 6 मंथ्स पर ऑथर इज टू बी पेड आफ्टर सिलेक्टिंग दीज 75 यंग ऑथर्स. नाउ 75 ही क्यों, बिकॉज of the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav we are celebrating. All right. Now any one of you can tell me that when was this Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav was launched? Tell me the exact date. Okay. देखते हैं कितने लोगों को पता है ये बात कि कौन सी डेट पे आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव लॉन्च हुआ था और ये कब तक चलेगा. ठीक है, सो हेयर यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. It is being implemented by Ministry of Education. Absolutely correct. The implementing agency is National Book Trust. बिल्कुल सही बात है. 75 authors have been selected under the scheme. Absolutely correct. ₹1 lakh scholarship will be provided under the scheme. Is that so? No. The amount of scholarship is not 1 lakh. That's ₹50,000, which means option D will be our correct answer because here we have to identify the incorrect statement. All right. And now let's talk about question number 4. In which state the Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairying under Ministry of Animal Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, which is headed by Mr. Purushottam Rupala, has launched One Health pilot project to implement the One Health framework by the One Health support unit? Very important question. So remember, the Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairying has launched this One Health pilot project in Uttarakhand. All right, Uttarakhand. And why? For implementing the One Health framework by One Health support unit. Now you must be wondering that what is the meaning of One Health here. So remember, this One Health India program has now been initiated by this Department of Animal Husbandry and Dairying in the livestock sector. Of course, this will work with stakeholders from various sectors to improve the livestock health, the human health, wildlife health and environmental health through technology and finance. All right. And there is one committee which has been formed. So interministerial One Health Committee has been established to lead the implementation of this One Health Support Unit. And who is the chairperson? Very important to know. The chairperson is not any minister or MLA or any MP. The chairperson is the principal scientific advisor to the government of India. So that's why this committee becomes very, very important. All right. Isse zyada detail mein jaane ki is news mein koi zarurat nahi hai. And therefore, the correct answer is what? Option C, Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand is the correct answer. And now let's talk about question number 5. Question number 5, 6, 7 bilkul direct question hai. We will not discuss about them because isme kuch bhi discuss karne ke liye hai hi nahi. So with which of the following organizations, Indian Express, which is a national newspaper, has organized India Education Summit 2022. So remember, Indian Express has organized this India Education Summit 2022 in which the Minister of Education participated, Dharmendra Pradhan. And remember, this has been organized in collaboration with Google. So option A will be the correct answer to this question. Question number 6, the recently signed India-Australia trade agreement, which was beautifully covered by Arushi ma'am in her current affairs sessions, will raise the bilateral trade to how much amount by the year 2030? Abhi jo India-Australia trade agreement hua hai, ye expect kar rahi hai hamari sarkar ki ye jo dono countries ke beech ka trade hai, jo ki abhi around 25 to 26 billion dollars ke aaspaas hai, ये 2030 तक इंक्रीज होके हो जाएगा. इट विल इंक्रीज टू 100 बिलियन डॉलर्स बाय द ईयर 2030. ऑलराइट. एंड द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे, व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग रेलवे जोन्स हैज कंप्लीटेड 100% इलेक्ट्रिफिकेशन अंडर इट्स मिशन 100% इलेक्ट्रिफिकेशन मूविंग टुवर्ड्स नेट जीरो कार्बन एमिशन प्लान. एंड डू रिमेंबर दैट इंडिया हैज अ टारगेट टू बिकम नेट जीरो कार्बन कंट्री बाय द ईयर 2070, which was announced by the Honorable Prime Minister during COP26. And of course, COP27 is going to be held in Sharm el-Sheikh city of Egypt. And talking about this question, so this question, the correct answer is what? Option C. Konkan Railway has completed the 100% electrification under its mission 100% electrification project. Okay. So option C is the correct answer. And that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll see you in the next session on Monday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.